It's my first time shooting a comedy, and I'm so used to be in a male-dominated environment when it's all about, you know, action and drama. And coming here and shooting this movie is just amazing because everything is on the lighter side of things. Jeff and Karen has their own relationship. Natalie and Tim has their own relationship, and then Tim bonds with Jeff, and Natalie bonds with Karen, and it really happened on set. I mean, we became really close. Awful, awful. He's very quiet, he's very, you know, amazing. I love him, he's the best. He's so relaxed, and he knows what he wants to get, and he's so sophisticated, because now I see that it's so hard to direct comedies, especially with people who has big personality, and they're really funny, and they always add up things. And I think that Greg is brilliant and is so easy to work with. I mean, he let us all just shine, and he let us bring our own personality into this, into each and every, you know, character. I always wanted to do comedy. I felt like I was doing, I'm very grateful for everything that I do, for every role that I get. Everything that I do, I love. But I was looking forward to do a good comedy. And when I read the script, it was so easy to read. And I was just laughing so much just from reading the thing. And then I heard who the cast are going to be, and knowing that Greg is going to direct it, it's like it's a dream coming true, really. Well, this is an action comedy movie, so all of the action things I'm familiar with. For me, the newest thing that I haven't done before is all the improv that we're doing on set, which is really, like, I really feel like I bring a lot to the character because I literally speak the character out without having the lines. Of course, we still have the scripted, and Michael, you know, he's amazing and wonderful and brilliant too. But the improvisation is the most, like, it's the newest thing for me. It's a new experience. She's an Israeli, ex-Mossad. She was recruited to the agency a few years back. She's Tim's wife. And they have a very good relationship, only that Tim doesn't share a lot with her. She's very dominant. She's very in control. They have a very good relationship. I think that Tim finds Jeff's a very good listener, and he missed this in Natalie because Natalie is so, she doesn't have the patience and she doesn't do a lot of talks. I think that Tim misses it, and he finds this in Jeff. And Jeff is all real, honest, talkative person, loves people. He's the opposite from Natalie, basically. So I think that's what makes Tim, you know, to fancy him. Ah, Zach is amazing. I mean, he is. He knows comedy so well. He understands comedy in such a phenomenal way. He delivers, like, No matter what you say, it's funny to me. That's the way you deliver things, like, in a very, like, he's brilliant. He's a great partner, so easy to work. Everyone, by the way, everyone are just great, so easy to work with. I'm very, very lucky. John is such a professional, very easy to work with, such a good partner, like, so funny. Isla said it before, and it's so true. He should have his own talk show because he's such a good improviser and he's so bright. Yeah, everyone are fantastic. Yeah, we haven't done much preparation. It was like the day before or something like that. And we've been working with Steve, the stunt coordinator, and everything felt right from the first moment. From the first moment that I saw the storyboard, I fell in love with it because I felt like it was so right. And it was such a good change from the cul-de-sac to see this heist thing and the craziness of the heist. And yeah, it felt great. Yeah, so we've been to the underground Atlanta, and we had dressed the whole place as Marrakesh, Morocco. And it was just gorgeous and beautiful, and everyone were wearing like the original clothes that they wear over there. And other than the fact that it was very dirty and smoky and dusty, I loved it there. It was gorgeous. In the dynamic between the two couples, I really feel like Natalie and Karen has a lot in common because they're both very loud, dominated women.
Hey guys, now the trailer for my big fat Greek wedding 2 is already out, but did you know that despite pulling in over 240 million, the first my big fat Greek wedding never once topped the US box office chart? Now for this and more movie facts, click on more videos, but if you want something different, click on the playlist.